أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تقولوا راعنا وقولوا انظرنا واسمعوا وللكافرين عذاب أليم. ما يود الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب ولا المشركين أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم، والله يختص برحمته من يشاء، والله ذو الفضل العظيم. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي، امين يا رب العالمين. يا ايها الذين امنوا، This is for the first time in Surah Al-Baqarah that we are having these words of Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. And please note that the whole of the Makki Quran doesn't contain this expression of address to the Muslims. In none of the Makki surahs. This is actually a typical term used to address the Muslim Ummah. And the Muslim Ummah actually was formed at Medina. In Makki surahs, Ya ibadiya allazeena amanu, Ya ibadiya allazeena asrafu, but not Ya ayyuha allazeena amanu. The only exception is Suratul Hajj. And about that I've told you that there is a difference of opinion whether that Surah Al-Hajj is Makki or Madani. This is for the first time. And this is to address the Muslim Ummah as a whole, including the Mu'mins, the Muslims, and even the Munafiqeen. They are also included in the Muslim Ummah legally. Ya ayyuha allazeena amanu la taqulu ra'ina. O you who profess to believe. This is how I prefer to translate it. O you who believe. I think the better expression would be, O you who profess to believe, who claim to believe. La taqulu ra'ina. Don't say, don't utter the word ra'ina. This was a social expression among the Arabs. When you were sitting together and somebody was speaking, and maybe that someone has not heard what he said, he used to say that, as if you used to say today, excuse me, please give me some concession, ra'ina. So they used to use this word ra'ina. But the Jews, you know, changed this word to ra'ina. And ra'ina means, oh, our herdsman. So to insult, to inflict an insult to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they changed the pronunciation of this word. Just as they changed ata'na to ata'na. And there was very close resemblance. We have just read in the previous session. Sami'na wa ata'na. Instead of ata'na. In the same way, instead of ra'ina, they used to say ra'ina. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the Muslims not to use this word at all. And instead use the other word, unzurna. Just wait for me. Just look towards me. Wasma'u. And you listen with the full attention so that you don't have to use this word. Walil kafirin azabun aleem. Or for those disbelievers who are using these words instead of the real word, for them is a very painful torment, very painful chastisement. Ma yawaddu alladhina kafaru min ahli alkitabi wal mushrikeen. None from those who have taken to kufr and disbelief, whether they are from the people of the book, min ahli alkitab wal mushrikeen, or they are from the idol worshippers, the mushriks, the pagan Arabs. None of them wants or wishes or likes أن ينزل عليكم من خير من ربكم. That some good thing should be sent down to you, O Muslims, from your Lord. This Wahi is coming to you, this Quran is being communicated to you, this is the biggest blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Neither the people of the book like it, nor these pagan Arabs like it. Why you have been blessed with such great a benevolence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَاللَّهُ يَخْتَصُّ بِرَحْمَتِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. And it is for Allah to decide whom He reserves for His mercy and blessing, whom He chooses for His mercy and blessing. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. And Allah is the owner of great bounty. مَا نَنْسَخْ مِنْ آيَةٍ أَوْ نُنْسِهَا نَأْتِ بِخَيْرٍ مِنْهَا أَوْ مِثْلِهَا. We do not abrogate any verse, any ayah, or make it, cause it to be forgotten. نَأْتِ بِخَيْرٍ مِنْهَا, except that we bring a better ayah in that place. Now this is a very important issue. Because although the deen of Allah has been the same throughout, the basic teachings of the deen of Allah are the same. From Adam till Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the deen has been one. But the sharias, the laws, the rites and rituals, the customs, they have been different. There was different form of salah in the Jewish sharia. There's a different form of salah with us. There were different rules for psalm, for fasting, for the people of Moses, alayhi salatu wasalam. There are differences in the rules about psalm in the sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now this changing of sharia means something from the former law has been changed and something has been abrogated and instead something else, something new has been given. Now the Jews took it, made it an issue of objecting on the sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you say that Moses was a prophet of Allah, if you say Torah was the book of Allah, how come? How do you change these things then? Why then change in the sharia? Why this change in these detailed laws of sharia? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had all the knowledge from the very beginning, why didn't He send the total and the final sharia from the very beginning? Now this is the answer to this. Because you know, the human kind was undergoing a process of mental, intellectual and social evolution. That process was going on. Hence there was a need of an evolution in the sharia also. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been changing the rules from time to time. And this is called naskh, abrogation. And this naskh is present in Quran also. In the beginning some commandment was given. There was a commandment, keep standing throughout the night, at least one third of it. Ya ayyuhal muzzammil qum illayla illa qaleela nisfahu wa binqus minhu qaleela awzir alayhi wa rattilil Qur'ana tartila. Keep standing for the half or two-thirds or at least one-third of the night. Then it was abrogated. You can't continue with it. It's beyond your power. So actually there are changes during the sharia of Muhammad, the evolution of the sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is why I said that the blueprint of the sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam we find in Surah Al-Baqarah. Then gradually developed into the final form, and that we shall find in Surah Al-Ma'idah. مَا نَنْسَخْ مِنْ آيَةٍ. We don't abrogate any ayah of ours, أَوْ نُنْسِهَا, or cause it to be forgotten. نَعْتِ بِخَيْرٍ مِنْهَا. We bring a better one or similar to it. أَوْ مِثْلِهَا. أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. Don't you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-powerful? He has the authority to do whatever He likes. أَلَمْ تَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Don't you know that all the kingdom and sovereignty of the heavens and the earth belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. And you don't have, and you will not find, besides Allah, any of your wali. What is, who is wali? Protector or guardian. Nor you will find any helper. No wali except Allah, no guardian except Allah, no protector except Allah, no helper except Allah. أم تريدون أن تسألوا رسولكم كما سئل موسى من قبل؟ Do you, O Muslims, want to ask your Rasul just as was asked from Moses عليه الصلاة والسلام before this? وَمَنْ يَتَبَدَّلِ الْكُفْرَ بِالْإِيمَانِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ. Whosoever exchanges kufr in place of iman, so he has gone astray from the right path. This ayah can be addressed to the Muslims as well as the Jews. Because the Jews demanded from Moses alayhi salatu wasalam, as we read yesterday, لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً. We are not going to believe in you unless you show us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we see him with our eyes, plainly. So they were making such demands from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also. So are you repeating the same? Is history repeating itself? Do you want to demand from Muhammad also the same thing as you demanded from Moses alayhi salatu wasalam? Secondly, this ayah can be related to the Muslims also, because it is not liked that you go into very finer details of these laws, asking question, if this happens, what will I do? If this thing happens, what shall I do? So asking these questions was forbidden. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He has given some commands, and He wants to limit that law to those details, the rest, you know, He has left to you. But if you go on asking and asking and asking, so your freedom will become smaller and smaller and smaller. And you will have more and more and more of burden on you of Sharia. So this is something which a man, you know, he, as if he is adding to his burdens when he is asking questions unnecessarily. There is an example that when, you know, this was declared that every Muslim who can afford, it is a farz, it is his duty to perform Hajj. Now somebody stood up and asked, sir, is it imperative and farz to do the Hajj every year? The Prophet just kept quiet. He turned his face, didn't give any reply. He again came to that side. Ya Rasulullah, I asked the question, is performing Hajj necessary, farz every year? Again the Prophet, you know, kept quiet. For the third time he again asked. Then the Prophet was angry. He angrily replied, if I say yes, it will become imperative for all times to come for every Muslim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want to put burden on you. And you want to add to your burdens. So that can also be in the background of this ayah. أَمْ تُرِيدُونَ أَن تَسْأَلُوا رَسُولَكُمْ كَمَا سُئِلَ مُوسَى مِنْ قَبْلِ وَمَنْ يَتَبَدَّلِ الْكُفْرَ بِالْإِيمَانِ فَقَدْ ضَلَّ سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ. وَدَّ كَثِيرٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَوْ يَرُدُّونَكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ إِيمَانِكُمْ كُفَّارًا. Many among the people of the book, that is the Christians and the Jews, they very much like and desire that they take you back from Iman and make you kafir again, make you disbelievers again. حَسَدًا مِنْ إِنْدِ أَنْفُسِهِمْ. Out of jealousy only. They know that you are now in a better position. You are in a better place. You are in Iman. But out of jealousy, they don't want to accept Iman themselves. But they want that you should also be deprived of this blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَسَدًا مِنْ إِنْدِ أَنْفُسِهِمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمُ الْحَقِّ. After that, the haq, the truth, has been made clear to them. And they clearly recognize the truth. Fa'fu wasfahu. So keep on forgiving them and ignoring them. It was actually a very basic policy matter that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also wanted, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also given the same instruction here, that after Hijrah, the Prophet wanted sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Allah also gave the same direction, to try to have peace with these people, these Jews at Medina. Because now the struggle was to start against the people of Makkah. So don't start any other dispute and conflict as far as possible at Medina. So actually, go on forgiving. Go on ignoring them. Don't argue with them. Don't in every matter question them. So that was the matter of policy that was being given here. فَعْفُوا عَنْهُمْ. So you go on forgiving them for all their treacheries that is coming in your knowledge. But you just don't bring them to book, don't investigate, Don't you know, argue with them, wasfahu, and just ignore them, hatta yati Allahu bi amrih. Till that time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings forth His final decision. Final decision will be the triumph of Islam, the superiority of Islam in the Arabian Peninsula. Then you know these people will also be brought to the book. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is powerful to do everything. وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَأَعْتُ الزَّكَاةِ. And you, O Muslims, establish the prayers and you go on paying zakah. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And whatsoever you send forth before you, before dying, you are sending these charities and good deeds of yours towards hereafter. That is your stock for the life hereafter. وَمَا تُقَدِّمُوا لِأَنفُسِكُم مِّنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Whatever you are sending before you, you will find it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Verily Allah is seeing whatever you are doing. Don't think that whatever you are doing, the good deeds that you are performing, are not in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَقَالُوا لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. And they say, who say? The people of the book, the Jews and the Christians. لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. Nobody will be able to enter Jannah, paradise, except who is a Jew or a Christian. تِلْكَ أَمَانِيُّهُمْ. This is their wishful thinking. This is their own thinking. These are the ideas framed by themselves. قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Ask them. Tell them to bring forth your argument. What proof you have? Bring forth Bible. Bring forth Torah. And tell us where it is written in the Torah. قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْهَانَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you are truthful. بَلَا مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. Why not? Whosoever submits his face, and face here means will. Whosoever has submitted his face, that is his will, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. And he is doing it out of sincerity, not hypocritically, not apparently only. مُحْسِنٌ, within the most handsome and beautiful way. فَلَهُ أَجْرُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. For him is his reward ensured, and it is with his Lord. And on them there will be no fear, nor they will have to grieve. وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ لَيْسَتِ النَّصَارَى عَلَى شَيْءٍ. Now just note these two ayat. In the previous ayah, they said, only the Jews and the Christians will enter paradise. Here the dispute among themselves. So they became one when they were against Muslims. But then, when you know they were between themselves, they were quarreling with each other also. وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ لَيْسَتِ النَّصَارَى عَلَى شَيْءٍ. And the Jews say that the Christians are not on anything. They have no basis. They are baseless. They have no deen. وَقَالَتِ النَّصَارَى لَيْسَتِ الْيَهُودُ عَلَىٰ شَيْءٍ. In the same manner, the Christians say that the Jews are on no basis. They have no ground under their feet. Their religion is baseless. وَهُمْ يَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ. Although they are reading the same book, the Old Testament is common between the two. The Jews don't believe in the New Testament. But you know the major part of the Bible, that is actually the Old Testament. وَهُمْ يَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ. And both of them are reading and reciting the same book. كَذَلِكَ قَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ مِثْلَ قَوْلِهِمْ. The same thing was said by those people who know nothing. That is the pagan Arabs, the Ummiyin, who had no book whatsoever. They also said that we are on the right path, neither the Jews nor the Christians. None of them is on the right path. مِثْلَ قَوْلِهِمْ. They also said the same thing, like they are saying. فَاللَّهُ يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فِي مَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ. So Allah will decide and judge between them on the day of judgment about all those things in which they were differing from each other. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ يُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ وَسَعَى فِي خَرَابِهَا. Because there was a mention of the pagan Arabs here in the previous ayah, Now you know the question of Baytullah that is being discussed. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ In a generalized way, it is this ayah is saying, who is more unjust than those who forbid from Allah's mosques that the name of Allah be taken there, remembered there, وَسَعَى فِي خَرَابِهَا And they strive for their ruin. That was the reference to the Quraysh of Makkah, who were forbidding the Muslims. They could not enter Masjid al-Haram, they couldn't make Umrah, they couldn't do Hajj, they couldn't go and make Zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over there, they couldn't go and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over there. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ يُذْكَرَ فِي حَسْبُهُ وَصَافِي خَرَابِهَا أُولَٰئِكَ مَا كَانَ لَهُمْ أَن يَدْخُلُوهَا إِلَّا خَائِفِينَ These people actually, they don't have the right to enter these mosques. Except with fear. Instead of having, you know, that they have become the guardians of this mosque of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Baytullah, Masjid al-Haram, these Quraysh, these Mushrikeen, these idolaters, these idol worshippers, these pagans, they have become the guardians of the house of Allah, which was built by Ibrahim and Ismail for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So they should actually be in a position not of guardianship, But even if they enter, they should enter with fear, not with authority. لَهُمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا خِزْيٌ وَلَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ عَذَابٌ عَظِيمٌ For them, there is humiliation in this world, and in the hereafter, there will be very grievous torment and punishment. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبُ فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَسَمَّ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ Now please note that this address to the Bani Israel is coming to an end gradually. A very small part of it remains. After that, I told you there are four sections of this surah which discuss the switch over of the former ummah being deposed and the Muslim ummah being installed in its position of representation of Allah on earth. And Muslim ummah is the representative of Allah on earth. Just as Adam was made vicegerent of Allah on earth. The Muslim Ummah is a representative of Allah on earth. And now for that purpose, Kaaba, because that was to become the Qibla forever now. Now that has been made, the mention has been made of Kaaba and Masjid-e-Haram, that it is still under the guardianship and control of the Mushriks. But because there was going to be a change of direction of the Qibla from Jerusalem to Makkah, this ayah has appeared here, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبُ Because it was going to be a very big issue, change of the direction of Qibla. For many people it became a tricky type of problem. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, has started discussing this issue, that this direction of Qibla, it is nothing. Allah is not confined to any one direction. East or west, north or south, all belong to Allah. Whichever way you face, that is the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's only for harmony, for a discipline, that a particular direction is fixed, so that there shouldn't be chaos. Whole of the community should be facing in one direction. The whole of the congregation, you know, that is facing in the same direction. For only a direction is fixed. Not that Allah is confined to that direction. Well, this is actually something, thinking very low of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the issue of this ayah. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبُ Mashriq and Maghrib, East and West, all belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا Whichever direction you take and face, فَثَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ That is the direction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the countenance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ Allah is, verily Allah is all-embracing, all-knowing. In whichever direction you are facing, actually it becomes the direction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's only for your convenience, for a harmony, for a discipline, that a particular direction is given so that all the people, all the members of the community are facing in the same direction. Nothing else. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا And they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has begotten a son. Now this is common to both. The Nasara, the Christians, they say that Jesus was a begotten son of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, begotten son of God. And the pagan Arabs, they had the belief that these angels were daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So both had committed the same crime. قَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا سُبْحَانَهُ. Glory be to him. He is above all these things. He is exalted. وَلَّهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ كُلُّ لَهُ قَانِتُونَ. Instead, everything that is in the skies and heavens and earth belongs to him, and everything is surrendering to him in obedience. Everybody, everything, every creature, angels, jinns, the humans, all the animals, all the skies and heavens, everything is obeying him, is in surrender before him. بَدِيعُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَإِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ. He is the originator of the skies, heavens and the earth. Now please note here, خَلْق and إِبْدَاع, these are two terms. إِبْدَاع, from this is derived this بَدِيعُ. إِبْدَاع means creation ex nihilo, creating something from nothing, no matter. Now there was wood, and the carpenter has made this table out of wood. There is something, and somebody makes something from that. This is creation, this is khalq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created men from the clay. The clay was there, and he created men out of clay. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created jinns out of fire. The fire was present prior to the creation of the jinns. But you know, in the beginning there was nothing. And that is ibda, creation ex nihilo, creating something out of nothing. So Allah is the creator of this universe, and he has created all these things from nothing. And then after that, he is creating from some one thing to another thing, something, and he creates another thing from it. But in the beginning, it's ibda, badi'us samawati wal ard. He is the creator of this universe, these heavens and earth, out of nothing. وَإِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا. And we, when he decides something, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. So he only says be, and it becomes. He doesn't need any matter to create anything, any material to create anything. No. Only his command, be, كُنْ فَيَكُونَ, and it becomes. His command is the only thing, and it is all sufficient in the creation. That is ibda, that is creation ex nihilo. بَدِيعُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَإِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونُ. فَقَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ لَوْلَا يُكَلِّمُنَا اللَّهُ أَوْ تَأْتِينَا آيَةٌ. And so said those who don't know anything. This is also the reference to the pagan Arabs who did book and scriptures. لَوْلَا يُكَلِّمُنَا اللَّهُ. Why doesn't Allah not speak to us? How come he only spoke to Moses? How come he only sends his wahi to Muhammad? Why not to us? We are more important in the community. We are the chieftains. We are the chiefs of different houses of Quraysh. But why didn't the wahi come to us? Why doesn't Allah talk to us and speak to us? Or ta'atina ayah. Or why has not a clear sign and proof, a mu'jiza, a miracle come to us? كَذَٰلِكَ قَالَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. These were the sayings of the people who were before them. The same things were said to Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, to Hud alayhi salatu wasalam, to Shu'aib alayhi salatu wasalam, to Lut alayhi salatu wasalam. All the people to whom we sent our messengers, they said the same things. قَدْ بَيَّنَّا الْآيَاتِ تَشَابَهَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Their hearts have become similar to each other. قَدْ بَيَّنَّا الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يُوقِنُونَ. We have made our ayat very clear, very shining, for those who have the belief, who want to have conviction. Inna arsalnaka bilhaqq bashiran wa nazira. We have sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with the truth, the total truth, the whole truth, bilhaqq, bashiran wa nazira. And you have two positions, two aspects. Bashir, giver of the glad tidings to those who believe in you, who believe in Allah, who become Allah's bondsmen, So you have to give them the good tidings. وَنَزِيرًا, and you are the warner to those who disbelieve, who don't believe in Allah, who don't believe in the resurrection, who don't believe in you. So you warn them that for them there is a very bitter and very grievous punishment waiting for them. وَلَا تُسْأَلُوا عَنْ أَصْحَابِ الْجَحِيمِ, and you will not be questioned about the people of the fire. You will not be held responsible that why didn't they believe? We have given them the choice. إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كُفُورًا. It's their choice. Whosoever wants to believe, let him believe. Whosoever wants to disbelieve, let him disbelieve. You can't press them. You can't compel them. So you are not questionable. You will not be held responsible for those people who are going by their own choice to the hell. وَلَا تُسْأَلُ عَنْ أَصْحَابِ الْجَحِيمِ وَلَنْ تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَا النَّصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. And neither the Jews nor the Christians will be pleased with you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, till you follow them, their millah. What is millat? Millat actually is a very collective word for the practices and beliefs of a community. If you don't take to their own beliefs, if you don't accept their practices, they are not going to be pleased with you. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't hope, don't expect that these people, you know, the Prophet and the Muslims, they had the hope because these people were of the book. They believed in Allah. They believed in so many messengers of Allah. They believed in resurrection. They believed in the hereafter. They believed in the fire of hell. They believed in the paradise in heavens. They believed in so many things. So many things were common. So it was easy for them to accept. And they were expected to accept gladly. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him, no. Out of jealousy, out of their pride, out of their haughtiness, out of their arrogance, they are not going to believe you. Rather they like, they would wish that you should follow them. They are the leaders of the community. They hold position. So they want that you should follow them. لَن تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَا النَّصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. And this is exactly what is happening today. Our own civilization, our values, these Muslim fundamentalists, they are challenging them. We have to guard them. This is, you know, the hue and cry in the West. So our civilization, our values, our culture, our system, our economies, well, these things are threatened by these Muslim fundamentalists. They should follow us. They shouldn't present their own culture, their own teachings to us. وَلَنْ تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَا النَّصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ قُلْ إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَى. Now, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives each one of us the courage to say these words with confidence. إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَى. We don't believe in your values. We don't believe in your culture. We say it openly and loudly that the guidance is only the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنَّ هُدَى اللَّهِ هُوَ الْهُدَى. All guidance, total guidance, real guidance is the guidance of Allah. وَلَيْنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاهُ. And if supposedly, please add this word here because these words are very bitter. If, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you follow them, after بَعْدَ الَّذِي جَاكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ, after this, that this knowledge has already come to you, مَا لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا نَصِيرٍ, then you will not be able to find for you against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to save you from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will find no wali, no protector, no guardian, no helper, وَلَا نَصِيرٍ. So these are very bitter words. So we must add the word supposedly. If supposedly, O Muhammad, you follow their wishes, instead of this Quran which has been revealed to you, after this has been revealed to you, then you will also become liable to punishment and you will also have nobody to help you, nobody to guard you and to save you from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. Those to whom we give our book, they recite it as is the right of its recital. as it should be recited. Now this word tilawa has two meanings. Tilawa means to recite, which we call in Urdu tilawat. In Arabic we have to pronounce it as tilawa. What is tilawa? Two meanings. This recital, reciting the Quran, and tala yatlu means also to follow. You know the famous surah, وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا. The sun is a witness to it, and its light and warmth also. And also the moon is a witness when it follows the sun, comes after the sun. To go after something, to follow someone, it is talaha, yatlu. So actually, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ. Whomsoever we give our book, they read it, recite it, and follow it. حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. As it should be recited, as is the right of this book to be recited. Now what is the right of this book? How it should be recited? Should it be recited without understanding? And if we recite it without understanding, are we fulfilling the right of this book? Should it be read only, not to act upon it? Simple answer would be no. It must be read with a determination to follow it, with a full determination to act upon it. If you are not reading it in that way, you are not reading it as you should read it. It's only a pastime. It's only a hobby. It's only to get sawab, you know, nothing else. So haqqa tilawatihi. Again I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He gives us the determination to fulfill the requirements of this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this book. The biggest blessing in this world is the book of Allah. The word of Allah, I told you. This word of Allah is with Allah. It's actually innahu fi ummil kitab ladaina la aliyun hakim. Alladheena atainahumul kitaba yatluunahu haqqa tilawatihi. Allahumma rabbana ij'alna minhum. Allahumma rabbana ij'alna minhum. Ulaika yu'minuna bihi. Only such people are those who really believe in it, who are not reciting it or reciting it without understanding. And reciting and understanding but not acting upon it. They are not the true believers in this book. أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. And whosoever disbelieves in it, then they are people who are in loss. They are the losers. They are doomed. They will be doomed on the day of judgment. يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اسْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِيَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ. Now these two ayat, they are closing the bracket. The bracket started in the beginning of the sixth section. Ya bani Israel, azkuru ni'mati allati an'amtu alaykum wa anni faddaltukum ala al-alamin. Exactly the same ayah without any difference of a jot. Ya bani Israel, azkuru ni'mati allati an'amtu alaykum. O progeny of Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam, remember the blessing that we sent upon you. We chose you out of all the nations of the world. We made you exalted over all the nations of the world. For 2,000 years, you were our representative on earth. We sent books after books to you. We gave Torah to you. We gave Zabur to you. We gave Injil to you. And we gave the scriptures to so many prophets. You have those scriptures in the Old Testament. The book of Zechariah, Yeshayah, Jeremiah, so many prophets. And the books are included in the Old Testament. So what, you know, blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had been coming to this community, this former Muslim Ummah. وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا لَا تَجْزِي نَفْسٌ عَنْ نَفْسٍ شَيْئًا. Have fear of that day of judgment when no person shall avail another. وَلَا يُقْبَلُ مِنْهَا عَدْلٌ. And there will be no compensation to be accepted from any side. وَلَا تَنْفَهُوَا شَفَاعَةٌ. Nor any intercession would be of benefit to anybody. وَلَا هُمْ يُنْصَرُونَ. Nor will they be helped from any side. The same four things which were enumerated there in the second ayah of the sixth section, they are also here. First and last are the same, but the second and third have only changed their position. The second is a number three here, and number three there is number two here. Exactly the same ayat, this bracket started and now ended. The direct address to Bani Israel is ending here. And now four sections of this surah, they are the sections which I have called tahwili, switching over. The switching over is from the former Muslim Ummah to the present Muslim Ummah. And the symbol was the change of the Qibla from Jerusalem, which was the center, the sacred city for them, to Mecca, which is the center and the sacred city of this Ummah. So this switching off of the Ummahs and this changing of the direction of the Qibla, that is the subject discussed in four sections now. And because between these two Ummah, the personality of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is common. Because the former Muslim Ummah also belonged to the progeny of Ibrahim. Ibrahim's son Ishaq, Ishaq's son Yaqub, and 12 sons of Yaqub, and from that, from those 12 sons, the 12 tribes of Bani Israel. And again, this new Muslim Ummah, that was raised on the basis of the prophethood of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also belonged to the progeny of Ibrahim through Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. So here you find, you know, this is the wisdom of Quran. Before discussing this change of the Ummahs, before discussing this, the issue of the change of the Qibla, first of all, the personality of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is highlighted here. In two sections, Ibrahim, Ismail, building of Kaaba, their prayer when they were raising the foundations of Kaaba, they are discussed. So that the common factor is made prominent first, and then you know the difference that will go, that was going to occur will be discussed. وَإِذِ ابْتَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَاتَمَّهُنْ. And just remember, when Ibrahim was tested by his Lord by so many big tests, kalimatin, so many commands, one command after the other, one command after the other, one test after the other, one tribulation after the other, fatammahum, and he fulfilled all of them. He cleared all of them. He was successful in all of them. The final was the demand of the sacrifice of the only son Ismail, which he begot after praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when that the only son of Ibrahim was 13 years old, and Ibrahim himself was 100 years old, then he was commanded to sacrifice his only son. And he didn't hesitate even in that test. He was successful. وَإِذِ ابْتَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ. And remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim in so many very big tests. فَاتَمَّهُمْ. And he completed all of them. قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Allah said to him, I am going to make you and declare you the leader of all communities, leader of all humanity. قَالَ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِي. He asked, and what about my progeny? Is this promise of you, will it cover my progeny also? قَالَ لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah said, my promise doesn't cover, doesn't relate to those people who are unjust. Now this question, this answer has two aspects. Yes, to your progeny also, but not to the zalimun from them. For your progeny also, the promise is there. Because after Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, Nabuwah, Risala, they were reserved for his progeny. For 2000 years, in one line of his progeny. And then the last prophet, the final prophet, that he also came in his progeny. So actually the promise was true with the progeny of Ibrahim also, but not from among those who were unjust, who take to shirk, who go astray. They are not included in this promise. وَإِذْجَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ مُصَابَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَأَمْنَا. And remember, when we declared the house that is the house of God, Kaaba, Kaabatullah, Baytullah, masabatan linnas, we declared it to be a place of visitation and pilgrimage for the people. Wa amna, and a place of peace and security. وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُسَلَّى, and we commanded the believers that the station of Ibrahim, you take it as a place of worship, of saying your prayers. Now what that means? The stone on which Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam stood when he was raising the walls of Kaaba. And it is said, the tradition goes, that as the walls were going up, the stone was also going up. Because there were no scaffoldings in those times. So building such a high wall of Kaaba, that needed something, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a stone. It's a miracle. But that stone is present even now, and after every tawaf, you know, two rak'at of prayer are said there, near that stone, that is the station of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Some people think that Maqam Ibrahim means Makkah, where he lived, so that is the place of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. But you know, most of the Mufassireen, they have the consensus, the opinion is that it is that proper stone which is preserved till this day. وَاَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ, and we took a promise and a covenant from Ibrahim and Ismail. أَنْ طَهِّرَا بَيْتِيَا, you keep my house pure. لِلْطَائِفِينَ, for those people who come here for circumambulation, for going round and round our house. وَالْعَاكِفِينَ, or those who retire here for meditation and for praying to me. اعتكاف, والركع السجود, and for those who are bowing here before me and for those who are prostrating here before me. Whosoever comes to this house to pay a pilgrimage, to do tawaf, to do اعتكاف, to do qiyam and ruku and sujood and say prayers, for them you keep this house clean. Clean apparently also. There shouldn't be any, you know, any garbage over there. And clean also from the dirt and from the dust of shirk. There should be tawheed. That is the inner cleanliness. وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ جَعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا, and just recall when Ibrahim said to Allah, he called Allah, invoked Allah, he prayed to Allah, رَبِّ جَعَلْ هَذَا بَلَدًا آمِنًا, O my Lord, keep this place, this city, this town, a place of peace and tranquility. وَرْزُقْ أَهْلَهُ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ, and provide the people who live here with fruits. مَنْ آمَنَ مِنْهُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, those of them who believe in Allah and the last day. قَالَ وَمَنْ كَفَرْ, because you know previously when Hazrat Ibrahim said, وَبِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي, what about my progeny? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا يَنَالُ أَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ, this promise of mine doesn't cover the unjust people. Maybe they are your progeny, but if they are unjust, they will not be included in this promise. So here Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam himself says, I'm not asking for those of my progeny who are disbelievers or who have gone astray, but those who keep to your faith, who have iman in you and in the hereafter, in the day of judgment, at least for them, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you provide them the peace, tranquility in this city, as well as provide them with the food through sending to them the fruits from all over the world. قَالَ وَمَنْ كَفَرَ, now Allah Ta'ala said, مَنْ كَفَرَ, whosoever takes to kufr, goes astray, فَأُمَتْيَهُ قَلِيلًا, to him also I will grant something for this life. I shall grant them comforts. ثُمَّ أَسْتَرُّهُ إِلَىٰ عَذَابِ النَّارِ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرِ, and then I will compel them and drive them to the fire of hell. And verily, that is a very bad place, very bad to return, very bad destination. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلِ, and remember when Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam were raising the foundations of the house, building the house, building the walls of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbana taqabbal minna. And they were praying, oh our Lord, accept this service from us. Innaka anta as-sami'ul alim. Verily you are the only one who sees everything, who hears everything, who knows everything. Rabbana waj'alna muslimain lak. Oh our Lord, make both of us, father and son, Ibrahim and Ismail, they are praying to Allah. Make both of us your Muslims. Make us submit to you totally, humbly. Keep us as Muslims. Please give us the courage to remain Muslims. Here let me quote the couplet from Allama Iqbal. Chumi goyam musalmanam be larzam ke danam muskilate la ilara. When I say I am a Muslim, I tremble. Because I know it's very easy to say that I am a Muslim, but it is very difficult to be a real Muslim. So that is the prayer of Ibrahim and Ismail, having that high position in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they are still praying to Him, keep us Muslims. Please give us the courage to remain Muslims, to remain in full submission towards You. رَبَّنَا وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ. And from our progeny, you raise an ummah, a community that should be submissive to you. وَعَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا. And show us our rights of Hajj and Umrah. What should we do? How to show respect to your house? How to perform Hajj? أَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا. Maybe they were shown to them in some dream. That's possible. أَرِنَا. Show to us. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might have sent Jibreel to perform Hajj and perform the rites of Hajj so that Ibrahim and Ismail could learn. Just as you know that Allah ta'ala sent Hazrat Jibreel to teach Salah to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Jibreel prayed with Muhammad. Muhammad was Muqtadi and Imam was Jibreel. And they prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in that way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Muhammad how to pray. So this salah was taught to him. So in the same way, وَعَرَيْنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا. Show us what are the rites and rituals of this house of yours. وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا. And have relent, have accept our tawbah, have a relenting attitude towards us. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Because you are the only one who accepts tawbah, and you are the only one who has all the mercy. رَبَّنَا وَبَعْثِهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ. Another prayer. And our Lord, please raise from among them رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ, a messenger, but he should be from amongst them. For them, a رسول, a messenger from themselves. يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ. Who should recite unto them your ayat. وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. And teach them the book as well as the wisdom. وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ. And purify them. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Verily, you are only, you are the Almighty, the All-Wise. This was the prayer, you know, for the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That you know, from this progeny of ours, this line of our progeny, from here a community should be raised. And in that community, a messenger should be sent. And what should that messenger do? Recite to them your ayat. Purify them. Teach them the book as well as the wisdom. وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَمْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ صَفِيَ نَفْسَهُ. And who will turn away from the millah? Again, that is the same word. The path and practices of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. إِلَّا مَنْ صَفِيَ نَفْسَهُ. Except those who have befooled themselves, who have put themselves in folly, only they will refrain and turn away from the path and practices of Ibrahim. وَلَقَدْ اسْتَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا. And we had chosen him in this world also. We had exalted him. وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. And in the hereafter, verily, he will be among the righteous bondsmen of the earth. إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ. When his Lord said to him, submit yourself. قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Whenever Allah said, accept my command, bow before me, accept this command, submit before me, At every moment, every time, the answer was, أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. I submit to the Lord of all the worlds. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ. And Ibrahim and Yaqub both, they enjoined their progenies, their sons, to the same thing. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ. What was that? The advice, the enjoining of Ibrahim and Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam to their sons. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى لَكُمُ الدِّينَ فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. O my sons, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for you the deen of Islam. So look to it that you don't die except as Muslims. You should be in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till your death. No moment should come in your life when you are revolting against Him, in rebellion against Him. You are breaking His laws, lest the icy hands of death pounce upon you at that very moment. Then that will not be the death of a Muslim, because you will be contravening the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at that time. If you are dying in a state of rebellion against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in a state of sin, that is not the death of a Muslim. Ya banayya inna Allah astafa lakum ad-deen. O my sons, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen this deen for you. Fala tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Look to it that you don't die except as Muslim. You don't die except in submission. Antum tu shuhada iz hadara Yaqub al-maut. Were you witnesses? Were you present when the death came to Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wassalam? Isqala li banihi. When he said to his sons, all the 12 sons were with him, when he talked to them at the time of his death, مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي. Whom will you worship after me? قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَاهَكَ وَإِلَاهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ. They said, we shall worship your Lord and the Lord and God of your elders, your forefathers, that is Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq alayhi salatu wassalam. إِلَاهُ وَاحِدًا. And He is one God. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. And we all submit to Him. تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ. This is a community. These were a people who have gone, who have passed. تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ. Now don't boast in their names. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ. For them was what they earned. All the good deeds that they performed were for them, not for you. وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. For you will be what you will earn, not what they earned. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ. This is a community, these are the people who have passed away, who have gone. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ. For them is what they earned. وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. For you will be what you will earn. وَلَا تُسَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And you will not be asked what they were doing. You will be asked what you have been doing. وَقَالُوا كُونُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَى تَهْتَدُوا. And they say, who say? The same Jews and Christians. They say, become either Jews or Christians. تَهْتَدُوا. Then you will be guided. You will be on the right path. قُلْ بَلْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Say, no. Instead, we will follow the path and practices of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, who was Hanif, who was absolutely without any shirk. وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. He was absolutely, wholeheartedly and totally a muwahhid. وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. He was not from among the polytheists, not those who worship anything and anyone else except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُولُوا آمَنَّا. O Muslims, you say in reply to them. They are saying, قُولُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَى تَهْتَدُوا. In reply, you should say, قُولُوا آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ. We believe in Allah. وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْنَا. And on what has been sent towards us. وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ. And what was sent to Ibrahim, وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ. And Ismail and Ishaq and Yaqub, وَالْأَسْبَاتِ. And his sons. وَمَا أُوتِيَ مُوسَى وَعِيسَى. What was given to Moses. And what was given to Jesus. وَمَا أُوتِيَ النَّبِيُّونَ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. And whatever was given to all the prophets from their Lord. لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّنْهُمْ. We don't divide between them. We don't discriminate between them. We believe in all of them. We believe in all the prophets, وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. And we are in submission to Allah and Allah only. فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ. And then if they come to believe just in the same way as you have believed, O Muslims, without any reservations, not claiming that we believe in Allah and day after, and the hereafter and the day of judgment, and they omit the Iman, the Rasul. No. If they believe just as you have come to believe, if they believe in all those things in which you Muslims believe, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدْ اِهْتَدَوْا, then definitely they are on the right path. Then they have got the guidance. وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, and if they turn away, فَإِنَّمَا هُمْ فِي شِقَاقٍ, then verily they are in antagonism, they are in enmity, they are in schism. فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ اللَّهُ, and Allah will suffice for you against them. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't fear them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be sufficient for your help against them. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ, and He is all listener, all knowledgeable. صِبْغَةَ اللَّهُ, we have adopted the color of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ صِبْغَةً, and who can be better in color than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. Now what does this color means? The whole attitude in life, the culture, the civilization, which is the result of Iman, real faith, that is the Sibghatullah, that is the color of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ صِبْغَةً وَنَحْنُ لَهُ عَابِدُونَ, and we are bondsmen to Him. We are all slaves to Him. قُلَ تُحَاجُّونَنَا فِي اللَّهِ, ask them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are you arguing us? You, O Jews, and you, O Christians, do you argue with us about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَهُوَ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ, He is our Lord as well as your Lord. He is the one Lord of all this universe. So what's the dispute about? What's the argument about? Allah is the same. Allah is the same who sent Moses. The same Allah sent Jesus. The same Allah sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَتُحَاجُّونَنَا فِي اللَّهِ, do you argue with us? Do you dispute us about Allah? وَهُوَ رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكُمْ, He is our Lord, our Master, and your Lord and your Master. وَلَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ, for us are our deeds, and for you will be your deeds. We shall not be responsible for you, and you shall not be held responsible for us. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُخْلِصُونَ, but we have become more sincerely devoted to Him and Him alone. أَمْ تَقُولُونَ إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ وَيَعْقُوبَ وَالْأَسْبَاطَ كَانُوا هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارَىٰ, a very beautiful, you know, expression. What do you say, O Jews and Christians? Do you say that Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq and Yaqub were Jews or Christians? Everybody would say no. Jew, with this religion of Jewry and Christianity, they have come after Ibrahim and Ismail and Ishaq and Yaqub. We can say that this religion of Judaism, it started with Moses at the most. Christianity started with Jesus at the most. So Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, they were neither Christians nor Jews. قُلْ أَنْتُمْ عَلَمُوا أَمِ اللَّهِ, say, are you more knowledgeable or Allah? وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَتَمَ شَهَادَةً عِنْدَهُ مِنَ اللَّهِ, who is more unjust than the one who conceals a testimony with Him from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ أَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ, Allah is not unaware of what you are doing. تِلْكَ أُمَّةٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ, they were a people who have passed. Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, they were a community, they were a people who have died, who have gone, who have passed. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ, for them was what they earned. وَلَكُمْ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ, for you will be what you will earn. وَلَا تُسْأَلُونَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, and you will not be asked what they were doing. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ وَنَفَعَنِي وَإِيَّاكُمْ بِالْآيَاتِ وَالذِّكْرِ الْحَكِيمِ.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.